As PLC programmers, we all know the struggle. Installing engineering software can sometimes take hours or even days. And when your project version does not match, you run into the mismatch error, which means more updates, more waiting, and less time actually programming. On the other hand, remote access is not always easy either. You often end up stuck on office computers, waiting for installation or licenses. If these problems sound familiar to you, this video is for you. And it's time for the change. My name is Rajveer, founder of Coding Compile, and in this video, I'm happy to introduce you Siemens TIA Portal Cloud, where all your engineering tools are pre-installed, always updated, and ready to use instantly right from your browser. So let's see what are the key features of TIA Portal Cloud. The first feature is zero install, always up to date. You have different TIA Portal versions, different engineering tools, which are pre-installed. So you don't need to install anything. And they're always up to date. You can use the exact version of the software that you need. And if your project is made on the old version, don't worry. We have multiple TIA versions. You can use the one that you want without installation. And they're always up to date. You don't need any VPN. You can access from anywhere, from your home, from your office, or from the road without any VPN hassle, without IT restrictions. So the question is how to get started. So in this video, I'm going to show you a live demo in which I will show you how you can sign up for this account and how you can create and simulate a sample project. And later on, I'm going to show you some ready-to-use applications which are already there in the platform. Are you ready? So let's open a browser and sign up for the account. All right, so I open my browser and I will type premiumservices.siemens.com. And when you open this page, you will see a service dashboard from Siemens TIA Portal, Industry Premium Portal. And we have to sign up for the account. In this case, you can click on this arrow here and click on login. So if you already have an account, you can just sign in. Otherwise, let's create an account. So in this case, I will just quickly put my information. File, country Germany, and my email address. And click on continue. And let's set up a password. And create an account. There you go. Now I need a verification code. So I might have received an email. So I'll just check my email and put this verification code inside and see if that works. So this is 241624. All right, let's continue. And now I should be ready to go. There you go, my platform is ready. Just some terms and conditions. Let's accept the terms. And now I'm inside my industry premium portal. So the first thing I need to do is go to TIA Cloud Services. So click on that, and now you will see various versions of TIA Cloud. We have full version, TIA Simulation Cloud, trial, and file share. So because we are going to work on the trial version, this is a trial license, I will click on trials. And now you will see version 17, 18, 19, and 20. None of them are activated. So we're going to activate the trial version of TIA Portal. So in this case, let's go to the latest one, TIA Portal Cloud version 20. Click on that, and you can activate your trials. So once you activate your trial, just accept some other terms and conditions. And now you can see that on the left side, you have an option to launch the instance. Click on that. And now you'll be ready to launch your TIA Portal Cloud V20. And trust me, it will not take much time. Just a few minutes. It's much faster than installing the whole software in your computer. So you can see some features here. Legacy version. Use outdated version. You can access TIA Portal versions that are not maintained by Siemens anymore, so you can use old versions as well. You have a hibernation mode. Now, this means if your instance, you just want to work later on, you can hibernate your instance so that you don't lose your work and you don't lose money if your instances keep running. You can hibernate that, and once you come back, you can continue where you left off. Prioritize access. So if you buy TIA Portal Cloud, you will get faster access, faster launch of your instance. Hardware access. You can connect to your local Siemens hardware using TIA Portal Cloud Connector. All right. So Cloud Connector is a piece of software that you can install into your computer, which will connect your computer to the cloud instance. And then you can download the code from the cloud directly to the PLC. Okay. So you can have a hardware access. And you can go online to your PLC from the cloud as well. you can have some quick access, which can directly let you start your instance. So seems like our instance is ready. You can see fraction of minutes. And now what we can do is we can see there are several softwares which are already installed. We have Siemens SP, we have TIA Portal V20, we have Sematic Runtime, we have PLC Sim Advanced and Normal PLC Sim WinCC Unified. So all we have to do is let's start with TIA Portal V20. And before I do that, you can see there is a folder which is called Application Examples. And if you go inside this folder, you have several examples ready to use. So you have Siemens examples, you have Access Control, CAMDIS, Line Motion Control, some Flying Saw Advanced, Filling Application, Filling Stations, TI Library. So if you say, if I go inside this folder, I have some Getting Started folder, here's the manual, and here's a ready to use project. And you can also see there's a tutorial that you can also use in your project. This is on version 19. So there are several ready-to-use examples already there. I'm going to show you a glimpse of that in the end. So let's open TIA Portal version 20, and let's create a very simple project. I'm just going to take some inputs, some timers, and an output. That's it. Just to show you how this works. This is much similar to working on a laptop which has TIA Portal already installed. So this is exactly the same. So click on Create New Project. I will keep the default information, and let's click on Create. So it's just like working on TIA Portal, you create a project. It's exactly the same experience like you do in a normal software. It's just working on the browser, okay? So now I'm inside the project. I will go to the project view, which is much easier for me to configure the PLC, but you can also configure the device here. It's totally up to you how you use this platform. So let's go inside the TIA Portal. Now we are inside. I would prefer to go full screen so that I have a better view. And now I can add a new device. Okay, so just double click on that. And in this TIA Portal V20, you can add PLCs, you can add HMIs, you can add drives, you can add PC systems. All the possibilities are here. You even have a new controller, S7-1200G2. Anyways, let's go to S7-1200. Let's take a generic controller. Let's say 1214C category. And inside this, I can take maybe, let's take this one, the last one. So that's the article number and that's the version. And let's click on OK. Okay, my PLC is here. Ask me for protection configuration. I would not do that because this is just a demo project. Click on Finish. And now my PLC is ready to be programmed. But I just need to check one more security setting. So if I go to my security setting visit, and if you go down, you will find an option of access control. I will disable that just for the demo of this project. So now I go to my program block, and I go to main block, and I'm going to write a simple piece of code. Okay, so in this case, you can see that the licenses are already installed. I can directly program the PLC. So click on the NO contact here, and I will take M0.0. And let's take now an instruction block, and let's call it T-on, which is my on delay timer. And it will take a data block, that's totally fine. Let's take preset time, let's say 5 seconds, and an output coil here, which is Q0.0. Okay, very easy. Now I need to simulate that. Okay, in this case, I can just go to online, go to simulation, and click on start. This will start my PLC sim instance. So PLC sim is already installed. You don't need to install that. It will just start the software, initialize the instance, and allows me to download this code to the PLC sim so that I can test the code before downloading it to the main hardware. Okay, so let's wait a few seconds. PLC sim should be starting, and we'll see an instance running. All right, PLC sim is going to start now. Okay, this is my PLC sim version 20. And there you can see my project one is here, instance one is here. It is going to initialize. Let's wait a few more seconds, and then it should be initialized here. You will see an icon here. There you go. This has been initialized. Now we can minimize that. And now we just wait for PLC program to be compiled to see if we have some errors there. And if not, it will directly download that to my PLC sim instance. So another warning, if you want to trust this device, yes, I will trust that. Click on connect. And now it will going to compile the hardware configuration, software, and to see if there is any error. So I hope there is no error here. Looks okay, successfully compiled. Click on load and let's finish. So everything is done. Program has been loaded. We can go to online. And now we can also monitor this project here. So click on monitoring. And now you can notice that PLC is by default in stop mode. You can see it is already in the stop mode. You can also visualize that in the PLC sim. It's not running. So I can run it from here, or I can also run it from here. Both will start the PLC in the run mode. Now my PLC is running. To test the logic, I can right-click on the tag, modify it to 1, and this will start my timer. You can see the timer is running here. And after 5 seconds, my output is on. Boom. Super easy, right? This allows you to simulate your logic. Fraction of minutes, and we are able to create our instance, code the logic, download to PLC sim, and if you use Cloud Connector, you can also download it to your real hardware. You see, without installation of any software, we are able to use TI Portal Cloud and connect to a PLC sim and simulate our logic. So this is about how you can easily set up a project, download the code into PLC sim. As I told you before, there are several examples that I have been working on in which I'm going to show you how you can explore ready-to-use applications which are already there in your instance. I've shown you the folder. You can open up this project and you can simulate that. So I've already played around with that. I've created some sample videos. I'm going to show you shortly how you can utilize this application and what is already there in TI Portal Cloud for you to explore. So let's start with the access control application. It allows you to monitor and control your motion access right from the web interface. You can enable or disable access, start-stop movement, perform homing, and even reset the whole system all in real time. You can run the system in jog mode, which allows you to jog the access in forward and reverse direction. You can run the system in velocity mode, which allows you to set the velocity with predefined acceleration and deacceleration time. You can use position access mode, which allows you to move to target position using defined velocity, acceleration, and deacceleration time. You can choose either relative or absolute mode of operation. Now we move to the CamDIS application. Here you can visualize and test electronic cam profiles, observing how a slave axis follows a master motion. You can analyze curves for velocity, position, acceleration, perfect for synchronized applications such as labeling or packaging system. In this example, you see a vertical form field seal packaging machine. This system automatically calculates the motion and the sealing profiles based on product length and production rate. It demonstrates how motion curves can be generated, visualized, and optimized, all within TI Portal and directly accessible to the cloud. Now let's look at contour mode. It used to program smooth, coordinated, multi-axis motion with linear and circular paths defined as contour segments. You can adjust velocity, acceleration to achieve perfect motion transition, ideal for dispensing, welding, or CNC-style movements. In contour OCS, those same paths are executed relative to an object coordinating system. This enables the machine to move precisely even when the reference frame itself is shifting or rotating, essential for robotics, printing, or machining on curved surfaces, all simulated and visualized live on your browser. Here is a packaging sequence created using semantic kinematic control. Each step defines a movement from pick to place across world and user coordinated system. This simulation shows how products are transferred between station, mirroring a real packaging process, all running virtually in the cloud. Pick and place. In this pick and place example, the motion is triggered by a conveyor sensor. The robot performs precise synchronized movements, picking an item and placing it at a defined location. It is a great demonstration of how event-driven logic and motion control come together seamlessly in Siemens kinematic system. And finally, create your own path. In this example, you can design and modify motion path directly on the HMI. No need to return to TI Portal. Operators can define the point of motion using built-in visits, fine-tune trajectories in real time, making adjustments during commissioning. This brings flexibility right to the machine interface, And with TIA Cloud, it's all done instantly through your web browser. From simple access control to synchronized robotic motion, TIA Cloud has it all. Motion, control, and visualization, ready to use anywhere, anytime. So go ahead, activate your trial license, give it a shot, and let me know your experience about TIA Portal Cloud. Feel free to write a comment, and don't forget to like and subscribe this channel for the next video on TIA Portal. I'll be making more content coming every month. So stay tuned. Until then, have fun. Bye-bye.